More than 6 weeks have passed since all the states in the U.S. have imposed their own versions of shelter-in-place orders to help stop the spread of COVID-19. Schools, business establishments, public places for gathering, and many more were shut down. But now, with President Donald Trump's push, all 50 states have begun lifting restrictions and reopening their economies, some slower and more cautious than others. On Wednesday, Connecticut, the last state to ease restrictions, has finally begun reopening malls, stores, and restaurants. The local daily, the Hartford Courant, showed these first images of people going out enjoying a sunny day. Meanwhile, in Michigan, factory workers are back to manufacture cars as the industry sets in place added precautions to keep employees safe. Some are worried but need the work, while others are eager to return to their workplace.
Let's go. Let's get this done. We got to do it sooner or later.
In Virginia, beauty salons are ready to serve their clients once again, but with added safety measures in place.
Glad to see everybody out and practicing safe guidelines.
In Georgia, while malls are open for business, not all stores are ready to accept customers. While in Texas, the state is preparing summer activities for kids to get them out of their homes and be active outdoors once again. With all states in some form of reopening, public health officials, particularly the country's top infectious disease expert, continue to issue stern warnings.
If we do not respond in an adequate way when the fall comes, given that it is without a doubt that there will be infections that will be in the community, then we run the risk of having a resurgence. I would hope by that point in time, in the fall, that we have more than enough to respond adequately. But if we don't, there will be problems.
Meanwhile, with the hope that a vaccine against COVID-19 would become available within the year or early 2021, the governor of the hardest hit state said this should be made available to all.
We have to make sure whatever company finds the vaccine, right, finds the pot of gold, that whatever private company finds that, the vaccine must then be available to all people. And it can't be a situation where only the rich, only the privileged can get the vaccine because one company owns the rights and they can't produce enough for everyone.
As of noon Wednesday, the U.S. continues to lead the world in coronavirus numbers, with close to 1,540,000 cases and more than 92,000 deaths. TJ Manatok, ABS-CBN News.